What is geothermal energy?
So geothermal energy is basically just really hot groundwater.
Really hot groundwater?
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's the result of a lot of magma and groundwater. Those are the two ingredients you need for geothermal energy. Boreholes can really differ. Some give us 7 bars of steam per the pressure. Sometimes some give us 15. So it just depends on the health of the hole. Mm-hmm. And we really can't control the hole. We can just predict how they're going to be.
Yeah.
So we can bore down there, and then maybe they give us much less pressure than we wanted. So. So we don't actually use all the holes at one time. Our deepest hole actually goes down to 3,400 meters, so it's 3.4 kilometers, so it's a long way.
Yeah. Is there any drilling issue?
No, not in this area. The drills can handle that depth. The biggest facility is in Northern California. It's called the Geysers. It's a really big one. They use it in Indonesia, they use it in Italy. There are a lot of places you can use it. You can basically use it wherever there's a lot of magma and there's a lot of groundwater. This is a geothermal power plant. We produce 303 megawatts of electricity here and 650 liters per second of hot water. Mm-hmm. So this facility both produces electricity for the grid and hot bathing water and heating water for Reykjavik. Because Iceland is a really volcanic area, and actually 1/4 of the island is volcanically active. The hot magma under here actually heats up the groundwater to around 300 degrees centigrade. So that hot geothermal fluid, as we call it, but it's just basically water with CO2 and hydrogen sulfide and some minerals in it. So we harness that fluid by boring into the ground to around 2,000 to 3,000 meters. And then it just shoots on up to us. We take that geothermal fluid, it goes into tanks where we separate all the fluid from the steam, and then we clean that steam a little bit. As is, we take the CO2 out and the hydrogen sulfide, and all the small water droplets, so we just have a really clean, dry steam. That steam then goes into our turbines, spins the turbine blades, which generates the electricity. But we also take that same geothermal fluid and heat up cold fresh water that you get from 200 meters, thereabout. Uh-huh. So we heat that up just with heat exchange. And that water we then send to Reykjavik with pipes. So this is the piping system in Reykjavik. So it's actually a pretty big system. It's around 3,000 kilometers of piping just for hot water in Reykjavik. So every single house in Reykjavik has got hot water pipes going into it and cold water pipes. So we don't have water tanks in the houses. We just have an endless supply of water. So if you want, you could in theory take a 5-hour shower if you would want. Mm-hmm. Never run out. Most of the electricity goes to big companies here. About 80 to 90% goes to big companies. So aluminum plants, mostly aluminum plants. Some to fisheries and greenhouses, but most of our electricity goes to aluminum plants because the kilowatt hour is so cheap here. It's actually cheaper for the aluminum companies to build the plant, move the aluminum from Australia or Jamaica, for example, smelt it here, then move it to the US or Europe for use. Because the piping system is so big, it would lay in one line, it would reach from here to Milano.